guys, your boy Pierre, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool promo where last time off I was picking up wins in the league and for two successful wins. I also simulated the last Champions League group stage game. In this episode, I have another league game, which will be followed by a cup, the quarterfinal cup game in the Capital One Cup, in which I have Manchester United. But first up is a trip to West Brom and the Horfans. So let's do that first, because, you know, the schedule says I have to do that first. I don't have a choice in the matter.
Hi everybody, welcome to you all. Martin Tyler here along with Alan Smith. Alan's been assessing the conditions. It's raining. Is that going to help the attackers, do you think?
Well, it normally does. Tends to lead to one or two.
So I want to get a nice early goal here against West Brom.
It's a free kick, and that's all it is. The referee is keeping his cards in his pocket.
Build upon. And a nice early opportunity, since they've conceded the free kick. Excuse me.
Hope we see more of the same.
Is this too ambitious? Screw it, it's Ronaldo.
Shots on here.
Am I? Oh! Wasn't going anywhere near the goal, except but and it turned into almost an assist thanks to didn't even think it was Rodriguez. So yeah. Challenge referee.
There is three guys for him in this position.
Avoids challenge. Avoids another challenge.
He claims the cross. It was, well, there's nothing
straight
to
the hands of Carrius. Wait a minute. Loris Carrius? Is it? That would be way up there in the irony scale of things if it is.
Well, I don't go that far from the holidays, and he scored. It's an incredible strike.
Is it? Hang on, I have to check. Huh. Nalo and Neymar are both playing tens, fair enough. Holy shit, it is! Talk about irony. If you're not, if you know, you're not following Liverpool, well, if you don't follow Liverpool or just don't give a shit what they do in the transfer window, or if you missed my previous episode where I talked about Carrius, because he's Liverpool's new goalkeeper. What are the freaking chances? Because I would come up against him. What are the freaking chances? Just that, not too long after he signed in real life for Liverpool. What are the freaking chances?
that should be another throw in.
Thanks for that, West Brom. I need a bit of the irony. He today? The irony of irony, just play irony. So, yeah, thanks. And steady dose of irony, thank you very much. Makes a man health here if he gets a good dose of irony here so often. So, yeah. In the most unlikely of circumstances, I'm coming up against a man who, come next season, well, pre-season, because he won't be with Germany at the Euros, so.
So we'll restart with a throw.
He'll be on.
Victor Wanyama.
He'll be at the pre-season matches. Is with Liverpool. Come, well, I'm not even going to say next season, because next season is pretty much already on us, because we're getting ready in a few weeks, the preseason friendlies. Preseason tournaments will be happening.
Liverpool's match at this point, but there's a lot more of it still to go, and they'll be wondering whether they see this through. Plenty of time left, all of the second half, of course.
Liverpool's new number one keeper, and I'm up against them as Liverpool.
And 4 minutes to play of added time.
And I would have actually come up against him as Borussia Mönchengladbach when I played the career mode. But obviously he wasn't Liverpool's new keeper at that point.
And it's a corner now.
Yeah. This is very ironic.
Great work by the goalkeeper. The ball is his and he's made sure he's protected it.
That's hard. I'm not gonna let that distract me though. Well, I'm still gonna be going to score as many goals as possible. And let's not bring up the performer anymore. Ronaldo.
Terrific stop!
Oh, what a save! Expecting lots of those next season.
Shut off now.
Bale. Ooh. Corner again. In our corner.
No nonsense defending from him.
Comes back to Royce.
That's a great clearance. Oh, great work by the keeper.
Oof.
Pedro Atiba. Liverpool will get the throw. Ricardo Rodriguez. Good distance to the clearance then. Typified the competitive
game, that tackle.
It's only a throw in. And they're getting the game going with a quick throw. Callum McManaman.
Give me that. Of course! That the computer can be annoying to play against sometimes.
It's a bad pass. He's giving it straight to the opposition.
Especially when they do that. I mean, that's pretty much all the computer do.
West Bromwich Albion, they'll be facing Barnsley. Yeah, and I've got a feeling we might. The goalkeeper comes out with a punch. Here's the cross. That's what a coach would want, to stop the supply into the middle.
Neymar.
Hello. Cleared before I can get a shot and a goal. Well, of course it is.
Rafael Varane.
Right, hit down the pitch. How did Ronaldo not win that? That makes no logical sense. Corner. I'll take it.
Substitute coming on.
Get off the pitch faster, I mean, maybe. Why they're playing you over Berhino when you were released by West Brom in real life is a goddamn mystery.
Routine for the keeper.
Oh my god, the deflection ruins that cross.
Well, they're playing Manchester United in the next match in the Capital One Cup quarter-final. I think they're going to win it easily.
Rodriguez.
And I do see them as strong.
And shoots! He's kept it out.
Oh, off the post.
They've gone for a corner.
Oh, no. It was actually saved, apparently. Or took a deflection off a defender. Either way, it's a...
Because the pressure was starting to mount.
It's a, it was a corner.
The supporters, Alan, trying to play their part.
Rain. Nathaniel Klein. Go, Nathaniel. Go.
Those players down on the pitch believe as well here.
Ah, bollocks. That's probably going to be yellow for Bale as well.
But they haven't looked like doing it because Liverpool haven't let them look like doing it.
Ronaldo.
Coutinho!
Succession
of corners here.
Yeah, I don't care. Yeah, I know it's a yellow.
By the official, but he's quite entitled to book the player now.
Well, he's always going to get a yellow for that, wasn't he? It was a silly challenge, and
Royce.
He's got to be punished for it.
We can check the corner count, Alan.
Going to come back to Royce. To the man's. Come on, Neymar! Neymar can get there. He got there, but there's no one waiting. Come to Neymar. I mean, Coutinho! Getting Brazilians mixed up! Ah!
Yeah, we,
I'm wishing I hadn't found out it was him now, because after I found out it was Karius, he dipped. Dipped in performance. Since I didn't... most of my shots were blocked, wide, save. I mean, that happens normally anyway, because it's legendary and the keeper should be saving a lot of shots. That's our worries, what's the freaking point? Like West Brom were able to bounce back and defeat Barnsley. Good for them. Guess I have no choice. Well, actually, I had plenty of choices, but obviously, I cannot play Brito because he got injured. In the game Brom won against Seville. So back to Old Trafford we go. for the second time this season. Let's do it. Of course, could easily be bringing Ronaldo on for another appearance against his former club at some point in the game. If the need, if there is a need, of course. I have confidence in the second team doing the job that I'm sending them out to do, which is get me into the semi-final.
Liverpool against Manchester United. It's such a serious rivalry, a very close rivalry.
This early attack at Turbay. Keep it in. Oof. Brigi, he was lurking.
We're going to see today, and they could cause one or two problems.
They've shuffled their pack today, Manchester United. Victor Valdez starts in goal. Chris Smalling starts with Phil Jones in central defence. Juan Mata plays.
Juan Mata. Ooh, I was lucky. I think it was Eriksen who missed the header. What? There, this might be my game, Chen. It's come to Martin Costa. Oh, Valdez, he got a hand to it, but it's still going into the back of the net. What? What?
It's a wonderful ability to have, isn't it, to connect so...
Initially, I was thinking that is a terrible cross, but the finish makes the cross seem pitch perfect. And Valdez tried his best as he can.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
To be held accountable for that. It was just a great shot that ended up in the back of the net. It is 1-0. Turbay. The second goal quickly. Iheanacho! Would you believe it? I'm 2-0 up in a blink of an eye. Iheanacho, which is probably the worst header I've ever seen in my life.
Certainly got the direction into the bottom left.
Clearly because Jones made it difficult. Valdez made... Now that one, Valdez can be held accountable for.
Margin here to 2-0.
But in pretty much no time whatsoever, it's gone from 0-0 to 2-0.
Nainggolan. It's a real tussle between the two of them to try and get the ball.
What's that? Aye. No, of course not. Should have known. You know, I didn't pay off all the referees. That's how they get a lot of their points.
This could be Eriksen!
Oh, what a save by Dragoski. And avoiding that corner. Although, I have to make sure nothing comes from this. Oh, the Nainggolan shot in. Elv Eriksen has gone out for a goal kick. I bet he's cursing Eriksen. Oh, Eriksen will have to score in this match to make up for that. The fact that he already missed a great opportunity before I scored my first goal. Well, Eriksen has made two big miscalculations in this match. I mean, it would have taken Eriksen with a heartbeat for him to look over his shoulder, realizing that Golan was going for the shot and get out of the way. And the miss header, you know, I guess you could say, he was unlucky, but still, he probably should have gotten to it. Mata.
Now he's lost the ball.
Sanchez. Okay. Oh, this punches it clear. Erchan tries to send it back, but Schneiderlin clears.
Throw in to come.
And I can't keep that in. Because why not? Why would I want to keep it in?
It's Juan Mata crossing.
Whoa! Mata, what are you... Who smoked? In. Motherfucker tried a shot cross. Or a cross shot. Ta. Iheanacho. Great save. Hey. Oh, how did Costa miss that? Oh, Martin Costa. Perhaps a bit of karma? Considering it was a missed tether that led to Costa's goal?
Complacency as well, Alan, haven't they?
Karma or just being unlucky? Hey, I will let you guys decide that. Was Costa unlucky or was that karma because the missed header from Eriksen led to the counterattack which led to the goal? In fact, it was the same. It was all one fluid moment.
Chris Smalling.
Hey! Origi. He forces Valde to concede the throw. That enters. Not for the first time this game concedes the throw right back.
Substitute coming on for Manchester United.
Win now, Orban. Thank you. Costa. Origi.
He's crossed it well.
That corner or goal kick?
I'm not surprised.
It's a corner.
And here's the header.
Costa. S cross. I begin. Fuck you, Texera. Oh, fuck you, Texera. And Eriksen's not going to get a chance to redeem himself in this match. Take the throw. Iheanacho back to Sanchez. Whips it in. Oh, come on, Niturbe. Put some more effort into it, okay?
Closing down well. The cross doesn't come in. Good defending.
Origi. He pretty much passed it into Smalling. Or ran into Smalling, however you want to look at it. He gave the ball to Smalling and that killed the attack dead.
Origi.
Costa. Costa! 3-0! Semi-final, here I come. Martin Costa gets a brace and it's 3-0. The undefeated streak is safe! And just to go one more, Man United, I don't know why I'm going with baseball terms, why not? Three strikes, and Man United are out!
I have to say, it's so one-sided today, but all credit to the team that are racking up the goals. Raja Nainggolan.
Turan. He's got the ball.
Well, that was a pointless corner to concede. Didn't put much thought into that. Never mind, Dragoski easily claims it.
One of those days when it's all gone right. Blocked by Blind.
Oh, Blind, you lucky son of a bitch.
Turan. Damia.
I guess that's a case of the blind leading the blind.
Not able to dwell on the ball for very long here.
Turbe.
And shoots!
Oh, what a goal from Turbe! Hey, I think that's his first goal of the season. It might not be.
The right-hand corner.
But if it is, even if it's not, what a goal. That would be a good goal in anyone's book. Like, and it's a very important goal in the career of Iturbe because, you know, it's just for Liverpool against one of their biggest rivals in Manchester United.
4-0 here and almost time up. What does this mean for their next game?
Well, Manchester United go up against Norwich City after this. All those players down there will certainly be hoping for better than what we've seen here.
Turan. Iturbe.
Turbe.
And he's moved in trying to jostle the opponent.
Blind can't stop him. Smalling can't stop him. Divo Origi. Oh, Jones puts in a great block. Dick.
Back into play off the cross.
And after Orban Chan. Someone put the ball in the back of the net. Okay, no one put the ball in the back of the net. Ta. Cleared by Turan. Gomez! Why did I do that?
That wasn't a very good decision to shoot from there.
Oh, collective groans right around this stadium.
Oh, that's hilariously bad. And there's the full-time whistle. Oh, it's almost a case of... They're considering in the last shot I took. It's a bit of a relief that. No surprise, the Turp in 9.2. He was very good in that match. Pitching as well as the goal. Oh. And the progressing teams are West Brom, Cardiff, Brentford. Brentford beat Aston Villa on penalties, but they beat him nonetheless. And of course, me. So, me and West Brom are the only Premier League teams left in the competition. Cardiff, a championship team, I think. And Brentford, who may or may not be in League One. I have no way of... Actually, you know what? Let's see where they are. Because I can't confirm or deny where they might... Here, one of the two teams could have been promoted or relegated. Oh no, they're both in the championship. Cardiff sit 10th in the championship, and Brentford are 18th. One place above Barnsley, who Aston Villa beat. So Aston Villa are better than the team in 19th, but they can't beat the team in 18th on penalties. Great. Great to know. And super. Or it looks like Leicester and West Ham will be on their way back. Great. Because I missed them, so... Actually, no, I don't. I don't want them to come back. If I'm being honest. But unfortunately, I can't affect the outcome of believe that is out of my control. All I can do is BAM when they come back. What's the freaking point? I have so much money in my transfer budget that at 52 grand doesn't make any sort of difference. In the next episode, I will have games against Chelsea and Aston Villa. Until then, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. And it's a subscribe button if you're new to the channel, so you don't miss any future content and from yours truly. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace!